Bocsánat, de nem előtt a lembom.
So, the first question, how to interpret the intranodular echogenic figures in this case? No answers? Then I... Please?
Comment, Theo?
I think that these are so granular forms prevail over linear forms, and the overall impression of this nodule that these figures can be microcalcifications, in contrast with the former case when the granular and linear forms were in the same portion. In this case, I think that granular forms prevail. This is not a classical pattern of microcalcification, but this is the pattern which we most frequently meet in our everyday practice. This proved to be a papillary cancer, so I think viewing the histopathological results, these hyperechoic spots must be microcalcifications. Yes, here we saw yes, this one, yes. I agree with you. This form cannot be interpreted other than a cometary artifact, yes. But it would be an unusual finding, but maybe. The current target states that if we see a cometary artifact, that the nodule should not be evaluated by cytology. This is a good example why the Koreans are wrong, I think. Naturally, maybe this is maybe a technical artifact, but who judged this as cometary artifact, I cannot oppose this meaning. So, the next. This nodule has a chaotic...
Can I add something?
Please?
Can I add something, please?
Please. Yes.
Regarding comet tail artifacts, they are not mandatorily typical for benignity, because you have to separate at least two types of comet tail artifacts. You have to take into account the ones that measure more than 0.5 millimeters, which are rather large ones, inside the cystic part of the nodule, and the others that are very tiny, like this one, which is a true comet tail artifact, but which is less than 0.5 millimeter, and rather located in the solid part of the nodule, because there are no real microcystic cavities in it. Probably only solid. And then, if you take into account this very small size and the location in the solid part, then on the contrary, it is in favor of malignancy, which is the case, obviously, here.
Okay. Thank you, Gilles. I absolutely agree with you. I only quoted the Korean meaning. The Korean target states that if we see cometary artifacts, we have not to deal with the nodule, and I think that this is not the appropriate approach.
I agree.
Yes.
Not everything is good in the Korean tirades, although I love the Korean tirades, but not on this point.
Okay. There is another feature in this case which meets our current topic. This nodule has a chaotic type vascular pattern. As Andrea has emphasized in one of the former cases, it is very difficult to gain adequate material from such a vascularized nodule. We have to make more attempts in such a vascular lesion, otherwise only blood will be appear on the smear. So this is a chaotic type vascular pattern. This is the microflow imaging which depicts the vessels. And the third one regards on the possibility of extratidal spread. Here is sign of capsule. Here is again. But great proportion of the nodule is not covered by capsule, great proportion of the thyroid where the nodule is adjacent to the thyroid lacks capsule. So this capsule is clearly discontinuous. This nodule bulges, it means that the the distance between the most ventral part of the thyroid here and the most ventral part of the nodule is around 3 or 4 millimeters. So this is clearly a bulging nodule, and it is very close to the edge of the thyroid, so the third sign of an extratidal extension, the abutting contours, can be also observed. So this nodule presents all three possible signs of a possible extratidal spread. Indeed, this nodule proved to be a T1 papillary cancer without any extratidal extension on histopathological analysis. So this case illustrates the weakness of this sign, and this is the cause, I think, why, for example, the European thyroid does not include extratidal extension among suspicious characteristics. I think you agree with me, Gilles, because you are the first author of this
thyroid. Yes, I agree with you, Tamás, because I only use these features usually in the other way around. That is to say, I use these features for their negative predictive value.
Yes.
And there we are quite good, but in the other way around, the positive predictive value is really not good, as you have perfectly shown it. So I totally agree with you.
Any comments, questions regarding this case? I will mute everybody, and if somebody will speak, then please unmute yourself. So I go back, so unmute all, and you have the opportunity to unmute yourself. Okay, we go further with the next case.